Greetings. If you are Muslim, I challenge you to watch this whole video. And if you have a question, please post it and start a discussion. Thank you, Brother Salim, for your question. I'd like to talk about your argument and the history of where it comes from. The verse says, "Try the spirits whether they are of God." Spirits mentioned in plural, so you believe in many Holy Ghosts? That's the first question. And you say also that Holy Ghost is God, so you believe in many gods? Any Christian can explain? 1 John 4:1. Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God, for many false prophets have gone out into the world. This verse largely exists in the Muslim awareness because one man from Islam made the following teaching. Let's look at a minute of a Didat speech, which is readily available to Muslims on YouTube.
But we are told it's a spirit. Is Muhammad a spirit? I say yes. That's what your Bible says. You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost. Because in the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are told that seven spirits of God went out into the world. I say, you believe in seven Holy Ghosts? He says, no, there's only one Holy Ghost. I said, look, he says seven spirits. I mean, it should be seven Holy Ghosts. No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
Now, I had not intended this as a video to debunk a whole Didat speech. But honestly, brother, to share the truth with you, I must do two things. Number one, I must show you the truth. Number two, I must address the errors of Islam. Now, let's go through it point by point.
But we are told it's a spirit.
Didat says, but we are told it's a spirit. There are actually several verses where Jesus, describing the Comforter, reveals who the Comforter is. John 14:16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Please notice, brother, Jesus says the Comforter will abide with, meaning live with, us forever. That he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of Truth. There is an unfortunate verse break in the middle of this sentence. Keeping the whole logical thought together, it reads like this. John 14:16, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever, the Spirit of Truth. The Comforter is the Spirit of Truth. And who is the truth, brother? Who is Al-Haq? God is the truth, brother, right? In Arabic, the word for truth is Al-Haq. So it is reasonable to equate the Spirit of Truth with the Spirit of God. I have no doubt an Islamic teacher would claim Muhammad is the Spirit of Truth. But doesn't that make Muhammad Al-Haq? Doesn't that make Muhammad Allah? There are other verses as well where Jesus, describing the Comforter, reveals who the Comforter is. John 15:26, but when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of Truth, which proceeds from the Father, he shall testify of me. You may not have ever heard this verse, brother, because it causes problems for Islam's invention that Muhammad is the Comforter. First, Jesus says that he will send the Comforter, whom I will send unto you from the Father. But Islam and the Quran claim Allah sent Muhammad. So if Jesus sent Muhammad, Jesus is Allah. Second, Jesus says the Comforter comes from God the Father, which proceedeth from the Father. The phrase proceeds from would not be appropriate to mean a messenger sent indirectly by. It would actually mean Muhammad came from paradise, from Allah. Does the Quran claim Muhammad himself was sent down? I do not think so, brother, but this is the kind of twisted invention Islam must make to defend their story. John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. This is another verse, brother, that Islam avoids, because it clearly states the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, the Hagion Pneuma, is the Comforter. It is so clear in the Bible, brother, who the Comforter is. It is the Holy Spirit of God. This is why spreaders of Islam must invent such twisted fables to change the word spirit into the word prophet. Now, brother, it is one thing to imagine this is simply just a Christian story against the Islamic story. We say it is the Holy Spirit. Islam claims it is Muhammad. It is much more than that, because the Holy Spirit is real and did exactly as Jesus said. The Christian account and record in the Bible is completely consistent and coherent. Having described the Comforter and having promised the Comforter, Jesus also said this to the disciples, Luke 24:49, and behold, I am sending the promise of my Father upon you, but remain in the city, meaning Jerusalem, until you have been clothed with power from on high. Jesus again repeats he is sending something. I am sending the promise of my Father upon you. And he tells the disciples to wait until, but remain in the city, meaning Jerusalem, until. This command to wait was confirmed in the book of Acts, which occurs after his resurrection. Acts 1:4, gathering them together, he commanded them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father had promised, which, he said, you heard of from me. This is how we know the city mentioned earlier was Jerusalem. For John baptized with water, but you, and this is Jesus speaking to the disciples, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Please, brother, think with an honest mind about what these words mean. With the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Days. Jesus did not say a holy prophet will come in 600 years, long after you are dead. Jesus said days from now. Brother, the word of God is completely crystal clear. Jesus had told them what would happen when the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, had come. Acts 1:8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. Brother, this is so much more than just choosing Islam's invention over a Christian book. Jesus over and over calls the Comforter the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And Jesus instructs what will happen when the Holy Spirit has come. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. When the Holy Spirit has come upon you. In fact, these were the last words before Jesus ascended back to heaven before their very eyes. After he had said this, they watched as he was taken up and a cloud hid him from their sight. So then, after being told to wait 4 days, not years, the disciples waited in Jerusalem. Acts 1:14. All these were steadfastly continuing with one accord in prayer, with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. Acts 2:1. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. The disciples obeyed and waited in Jerusalem until. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. This is 50 days after the resurrection. And suddenly there came from heaven a noise like a violent rushing wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as of fire distributing themselves, and they, the tongues of fire, rested on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit was giving to them to utter forth. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. The Comforter, the real Comforter, the Holy Spirit of God, came upon them and filled them as was told and promised. From John 14:17, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him, you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. Acts 2:4 says, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Will be in you. Filled in you. Now they would be filled. The Holy Spirit would be in them. Brother, the historical record of the events, comprised of Jesus' words and the descriptions and the events themselves, are all in consistent, coherent harmony. Christians know the Comforter is the Holy Spirit of God, and that he came as promised. It is your choice, brother. Use your logical mind and consider the full Christian claim about the Comforter, the Holy Spirit of God. This is not a matter of one word, Spirit, simply being twisted by Christians to mean Holy Spirit, so that we can somehow avoid obeying and bending over to Muhammad. We have the truth, brother. We have the Spirit of truth available to us, living in us. Every Christian should be able to declare they know the truth, and they know that they know. I told you, brother, that I needed to do two things. One, I must show you the truth. Two, I must address the errors of Islam. In all honesty, I have only been able so far to present some of the real truth that the Comforter is the Holy Spirit. A brief summary is that the Holy Spirit actually was given as Jesus promised. And the New Testament is filled with his contribution, his work, him doing just what Jesus promised. All of which proves the disciples did not just wrongly imagine some ghost fulfilled Jesus' promise. In the next video, I will focus on that aspect of the purpose and ministry of the Comforter, brother. The documented record of the real Holy Spirit of God working with the disciples as Jesus promised. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.